our Father, who art in heaven, Lord, who made heaven and earth, glory be, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I welcome all of you to Holy Trinity Cathedral of our Polish National Catholic Church here in Manchester, New Hampshire, as we celebrate this fourth Sunday of Lent, also known as Laetare Sunday, when we go from purple to rose vestments for this day, just to give us a break from the aspect of penitential that we've been experiencing all through Lent, to experience that joy that will be coming with the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on Easter morning. Today, before we begin the Mass, I remind you also that we will be conferring the sacrament of the sick after the sermon today. So I invite all of you to come forward to receive the anointing of the sick, even if you are not sick physically, but remember that the grace of the sacrament provides healing to ailments, both physical and spiritual. So we encourage everybody in church to come forward after the sermon to receive the anointing of the sick. Also, I want to very quickly remind you that this will be the last day that you'll be seeing the warm clothing for the needy, for families in transition, because this week all of the clothing will be going to their center for distribution to people in need, either still this year or they will be used for next year. You do have the alms boxes. We remind you of those as well, because that will be provided for the Afghan refugees that have been resettled into our community of Manchester to help them have a beginning. And we also are still collecting and will through next Sunday, and we may go on into the future, but we are collecting. And according to our parish committee chairperson, we're almost there for the matching program. At our parish committee meeting 2 weeks ago, the parish committee decided to give $5,000 to the Ukraine and an additional $5,000 in matching funds. So everything that is donated to the church up to $5,000 will also be matched by the church. So we're almost at that point, or just about at that point, of $10,000 from our parish that will be going to the Ukraine. But if it's more than that, that's a blessing as well. Please support this, as all of the parishes of our Polish National Catholic Church are supporting our churches in Poland that are doing the grassroots work on the ground. There's one church, for example, that has converted their entire auditorium into a storage area where they have medicine, food, clothing, and they also have set up 200 cots for refugees to stay in. And they take a truck, and every other day they drive from the church to the border, to the Ukraine border. They dump off all of this supplies that they have, and then they put refugees in their trucks and bring them back to stay at that temporary shelter until they can find lodging for them. So this type of work is what they're doing, but also it takes funding. And so that's what we're going to try to support as a church, to help the Ukrainian refugees that are in Poland. And there are more than 2.5 million refugees in Poland now, and many of them have nothing to go back to, because everything they've had has been destroyed. So if they're going, this is not a one or a two or three week effort. This will take time to help these people, and I ask for contributions for them, for the Afghan resettlement that we have in our own community, and for the work that we do in clothing folk, like we have in clothing in the back of the church. This is what we are called to do as Christian men and women in discipleship, following our Lord and Savior's lead, when he said, "The way you treat the least among us, that's how you treat me." So let us treat our Lord well. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, I will go to the altar of God.
God, you save my soul.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, Laetare Sunday calls us to rejoice, and we hear profound reasons for joy in the story of the prodigal son. Today's readings focus on reconciliation, forgiveness, and moving forward. Forgiveness is one-sided. One can choose to forgive, but reconciliation requires two people in the act of coming together. God offers us both forgiveness and reconciliation and does not hold our sins against us once we have asked for forgiveness. Are we able to do the same with one another? A question for us to ponder as we prepare ourselves to participate in today's holy sacrifice. Please make a quiet examination of your conscience at this time and confess your sins to God. Please say with me now the second form of the Confiteor. I confess to Almighty God, one in the Holy Trinity, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by my own great fault. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon, absolution, and remission of our sins.
Amen.
May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I do absolve you from all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O God, you will again renew us. Show us your mercy, Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let our cry come to you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Take our sins away from us, Lord, so we may enter the Holy of Holies with purified hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord commanded the skies above, the doors of heaven he opened. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be, the world without end.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Peace be with you. Desires, so that we may always live in Christ and He in us. We ask that through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
On that that same day after the Passover, in which they ate of the produce of the land, the manna ceased. No longer was there manna for the Israelites, who that year ate of the yield of the land of Canaan. This is the word of the Lord. This makes us ambassadors for Christ. God, as it were, appealing through us, we implore you, in Christ's name, be reconciled to God. For our sakes, God made him who did not know sin to be sin, so that in him we might become the very holiness of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Treat me like one of your hired hands. And with that, he set off.
While he was still a long way off, his father caught sight of him and was deeply moved. He ran out to meet him, threw his arms around his neck, and kissed him. The son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against God and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son." The father said to his servants, "Quick, bring out the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and shoes on his feet. Take the fatted calf and kill it. Let us eat and celebrate, because this son of mine was dead and has come back to life. He was lost and is found." Then the celebration began. Meanwhile, the elder son was out on the land. As he neared the house on his way home, he heard the sound of music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked him the reason for the dancing and the music. The servant answered, "Your brother is home, and your father has killed the fatted calf, because he has him back in good health." The son grew angry at this and would not go in. But his father came out and began to plead with him. He said in reply to his father, "For years now I have slaved for you, and I never disobeyed one of your orders, yet you never gave me so much as a kid goat to celebrate with my friends. Then when this son of yours returns after having gone through your property with loose women, you kill the fattened calf for him." "My son," replied the father, "you are with me always, and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and rejoice. This brother of yours was dead and has come back to life. He was lost and is found." This is the gospel of the Lord. Today, we celebrate Laetare Sunday, and the key to this Sunday celebration is the gospel message of the prodigal son, a very, very well-known story that Jesus tells as he tries to teach his people about reconciliation. And in fact, that's what the church is focusing in on. The entire Mass today is the idea of reconciliation, of being reconciled one to another, we to God, and then we also to our brothers and sisters. In fact, the prodigal son story has the son that went away and spent all his father's money, half of the money at least, on loose women and terrible debauchery, returns and is not only forgiven, but he's given the ring, and he's given a purple cloak to wear. And then the father then has to go to the other son who never left him, and there is a need for reconciliation there, because the Son is the Son remained with the Father is upset because of the action of the Father towards the Son that left him, and the Father says, "Don't you know we have to do this because your brother was dead, but he's alive again." And it, the implication is, the Son has to be the two sons have to be reconciled to one another. But Jesus leaves it there, and we don't know if the sons reconciled to each other. Our prayer, though, is that they did, because it just makes sense to do so. But we don't know if it happens or not. In the first reading today, we hear that moment when Joshua and the people of Israel, after their spending 40 years in the Egyptian, in the desert, after their exodus from Egypt, an entire generation passes away, an entire generation of Hebrew people grows up in the desert, and for 40 years God has been feeding them with manna and quail and water from the rock. And we hear in the story, in the portion from Exodus today, that this is the moment when they enter into the land. They eat for the very first time, not manna and not quail, but they're eating grain. They're eating stuff that has actually grown from the ground. And from that point on, there is no need to feed them again. There is no need to provide them with manna from heaven, with the quail, with the water, because now this entire generation who has been reared in God and has developed their relationship to him, completely reconciled from the generation that had preceded them, that had questioned everything that God ever did with them, even though he continued to bless them, he never stopped loving them. That entire generation would question and oppose God, and it took this new generation that would come up, and they would be the one under Joshua that would enter the promised land. And they are reconciled to God, and they are reconciled to one another, and all of a sudden, they are able to provide for themselves from the land. And even in the second reading that we hear today in Paul's letter to the Corinthians, it says, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old order has passed away, now all is new. And then he continues, all this has been done by God, who has reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That's important to understand. He has given us the ministry of reconciliation. So as disciples, as followers of Jesus, we are called to reconcile ourselves with one another. We're called to lay down all those sins that we've been carrying, all those grudges that we've had in our hearts and in our souls for way too long a time, and we're supposed to lay that all down and place that burden on Jesus. And in fact, Jesus takes up that burden on Good Friday, and he carries it to the cross, and with Jesus' death on the cross, all the sins that we have committed are dead too, and we are newly alive in Christ Jesus our Lord. And Paul continues, this makes us ambassadors for Christ, God, as it were, appealing through us. The fact that we now can reconcile ourselves to one another, that we can be reconciled to God, we can now represent God and take the message of hope and reconciliation to all of the people outside the doors of this church that are seeking for love, seeking for mercy, seeking for kindness. Today's Mass is entirely about reconciliation, and what better time than to receive the sacrament of anointing of the sick, because anything that is in our hearts and our minds that are binding us to sin can now be removed as we approach the altar and receive this great sacrament, this gift of reconciliation that God gives to his people through his church, the sacrament of the anointing of the sick. Not only the sick who are physically ill, but those who are burdened in their hearts and their souls with sin and a separation, and the opportunity we are given by God to accept His love in this special way, to change our hearts and to become His ambassadors to the world. So I hope that all of you will come forward to receive this sacrament of the reconciliation of the sick, and may we together carry the promise and the hope of reconciliation to all of those that we meet today and all of our days into the future. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our God instructed the church through the words of St. James the Apostle. Is anyone among you suffering? He should pray. Is anyone among you sick? He should summon the presbyters of the church, and they should pray over him and anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick person, and the Lord will raise him up. If he has committed any sins, he will be forgiven. Let us pray. We ask you, Lord God, to bestow your healing power upon our congregation. By the sacrament of holy anointing and by their faith, may the souls of those who will now come forward to be cleansed from even the slightest stain of sin. Restore them to spiritual health, and grant that by this holy sacrament they may rejoice in the state of regenerating grace that is theirs in the victory of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Holy Spirit, awaken in the hearts of our brothers and sisters a true repentance for their sins. Bestow upon them your sacramental grace, and as you perceive the weakness and the infirmity of their weakness and infirmity, restore them to spiritual health and preserve them from danger. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Those who would like to receive the sacrament now are asked to come forward. Merciful and gracious to you.
May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins that you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health.
They shall lay their hands upon
their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins that you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins that you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his great gracious mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins that you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing, may the Lord God forgive you any sins that you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen. Through this holy anointing and by his tender mercy, may the Lord God forgive you any sins you may have committed and grant you health. Amen. They shall lay their hands upon the sick and they shall be made well again. May Jesus, the Son of God, the Lord of all creation, through the merits and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all of the apostles and all of the saints, be merciful and gracious to you and grant you health. Amen.
us together proclaim the faith that we share. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. Our Savior was crucified in the house of Christ, and he suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again. The fulfillment of the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one and holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
I acknowledge my baptism
for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world.
May they whose memory be on our earth intercede for us in heaven. We ask this through Jesus. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Almighty God, through these gifts we offer, help us to forsake the passing pleasures of life for the eternal joy of your home. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. To make it pleasing to yourself,
so that it may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and become for us the body and the blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before his suffering and death, in order to manifest his infinite love to his disciples, and through them to all who believe in him, to fill the hearts of his followers with the fire of this love, draw them to himself, make them joyful, and save them, he instituted these holy mysteries in which, spiritually and bodily, in his entire being, he again lives among his people. At that solemn moment, so sacred for the whole human family, our Savior took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having lifted his eyes to heaven, to you, his almighty Father, giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." Saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." Therefore, in remembrance of this Christ, your Son, our Lord, in his blessed Passion, Resurrection, and his glorious Ascension, we, your servants and faithful people, offer to your Divine Majesty from your own gifts and presents a pure offering, a holy offering, an immaculate offering, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to regard these offerings with favor and joy, and accept them as you receive the gifts of your just servant Abel, the sacrifice of our patriarch Abraham, and that which your high priest Melchizedek offered you, a holy sacrifice and immaculate host. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, command that this offering be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your high altar into the presence of your divine majesty, that we who receive the most sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar may be filled with every blessing and grace through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and sleep in peace. We remember all of those who have died because of the COVID-19 virus, all of those who have died in war, especially in the Ukraine. We also remember the soul of Joseph Honig Sr. on the 45th anniversary of his death. To these souls, Lord, and all who rest in Christ, grant, we pray, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. And grant us, your sinful servants, who hope in the graces, the greatness of your mercy, some part in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, and all your saints who shed their blood for your name. Their hearts were always open to justice and mercy, and with lives patterned after their divine master, merited eternal joy. Number us in their company, Lord, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Christ, our Lord. Amen. By whom you always create, sanctify, revive, bless, and freely give us all these good things. Through him, with him, and in him, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Thank you. past, present, and future, and by the intercession of the blessed and glorious Mother of God, Mary, together with your blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and also Andrew, and all the saints, grant us peace in our day, supported by the help of your mercy. May we be always free from sin and secure from all disturbance, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cost for my judgment or condemnation, though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness may it become my safeguard and healing remedy. My saving master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite me entirely with you, my Lord and my God. Grant this, who lives and reigns with God the Father, in unity with the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. Amen.
away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Remain with you now and forever. Amen. Body and the blood of Christ.
receive with our lips, may we understand with our minds, and may this temporal gift become for us an everlasting healing. May your body, which I have received, and your blood, which I have drawn, cling to my inmost being, and grant that no sin remain in me, whom these holy sacraments have nourished, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Let us pray. All-loving and forgiving Father, have mercy on us who have shared at your table, renewed by the body and blood of your Son. May we be found worthy to be called your children. We ask this in the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Peace be with you. Karen, if you would.